Very good evening, students. I welcome you all to what we need discussion part 2 on the topic microbes in human welfare. Dear students, yesterday we had discussed around 31 questions. With the continuation of the same topic, we are going to discuss a few more questions on the topic the microbes in human welfare. Students, question number 32. The following is an aerobic free living nitrogen fixing soil bacterium. Options: 1. Clostridium, 2. Acetobacter, 3. Klebsiella, 4. Rhizobium. Students, as you all know, the Clostridium, Klebsiella are the facultative anaerobic microorganism. They can also fix the nitrogen, but they are facultative anaerobic, whereas Rhizobium is a symbiotic. It is a symbiotic. Bacteria which forms association with leguminous plants. So they form on the nodules of the root. So Rhizobium are the symbiotic bacteria, whereas Acetobacter, you see, is a free living nitrogen fixing soil bacteria, which is generally found in most of the cotton maize fields. Okay, so yesterday I said that it was the first biofertilizer to be incorporated for these kinds of crops like cotton and maize. And apart from that, the trade name of which is sold this biofertilizer is Acetobacterin. Acetobacterin is the brand name or trade name by which this particular biofertilizer was sold. Question number 33. The yield of paddy can be increased by the application of, now you all know the rice cultivation, where the farmers say that 50% of the crop yield can be enhanced with the use of the cyanobacteria. Among the given options, option number 1, Nostoc, symbiotic bacteria, iron bacteria and archibacteria. You know that Nostoc is a cyanobacteria. It is a cyanobacteria. So this is the perfect match for the cyanobacteria. Whereas second, symbiotic bacteria is used in leguminous plants. Iron bacteria, it is not a, you can say, the used in paddy field. Archaebacteria also, they are found in the harsh environment. So the yield of paddy can be increased by the application of Nostoc. Along with Nostoc, you know, Oscillatoria, Allocera are few of the cyanobacteria which can be used. Question number 34. Nitrogen fixation organism is, option number 1, Nitrosomonas, option number 2, E. coli, that is Escherichia coli, option number 3, Nitrobacter, option number 4, Rhizobium and Acetobacter. Dear students, you know Nitrosomonas is involved in nitrification, right? So nitrification, you have studied the nitrogen cycle in the first year. Now when I say in fixation of nitrogen, it is the conversion of dinitrogen or the atmospheric nitrogen into soluble, or you can say usable form, that is ammonia, right? So the Nitrosomonas is a nitrification. It nitrifies, the converts the nitrates into nitrites. Whereas E. coli, you know, it is generally found in the soil, as well as it is a colon bacteria found in the human flora. Nitrobacter, again, it is involved in the nitrification process. Rhizobium and Acetobacter are free living nitrogen fixer. So among the given options, option number 4 is the right answer. Rhizobium is a symbiotic nitrogen fixer, whereas Acetobacter, it is a free living. It is a symbiotic, it is free living. Question number 35. The symbiotic nitrogen fixing bacteria present in root nodules of legumes belongs to genus. Now, since they have asked symbiotic nitrogen fixing, we have already discussed the important genus is Rhizobium. Rhizobium. You have Azorhizobium. Bradyrhizobium. Photorhizobium. Cyanorhizobium. These are various genuses that could be one of the options. Now, among the four options, the first option is Xanthomonas. You know, Xanthomonas is a pathogen that causes various bacterial infections to many of the crop yields, like in citrus, Xanthomonas citri, which causes the citrus canker disease. The Pseudomonas, which is again, it is a denitrifying bacteria. Whereas Rhizobium is the option three is right here, whereas Estobacter, it is a free living nitrogen bacteria. Since they have asked for the symbiotic nitrogen fixation, so our answer would be option number three. Option number three, Rhizobium is the right answer. Question number 36. Which of the following groups of plants are highly useful in increasing soil fertility? Dear students, this question which are given is little typographical error, I could say. So among the given options, the red algae, the fungi, the bacteria, they aren't the plants. But since they have asked for the groups of plants, the option you should correct it as pteridophytes. Okay, it's a, you know, in paddy fields, the pteridophytes, the ferns such as the Azolla pinnata is a fern which increases the soil fertility. That should be the option. So since pteridophytes, they don't have any suiting matches here. So kindly correct it. You take it as pteridophytes. So among the given options, you see red algae, fungi, bacteria. Apart from that, pteridophytes also, they enhance the soil. So option number four would be the right answer. So it is a mistake that has happened from our end. Question number 37, the biological process carried on by Rhizobium is called. It's a very simple question. Just now we discussed that the Rhizobium, Cyanorhizobium, Bradyrhizobium, Photocyanorhizobium, these all are what? They are the symbiotic nitrogen fixers. They form the nodules on the roots of leguminous plants. You have already learned in detail about the process of nitrogen fixation in your 11th class. So the right answer would be nitrogen fixation. Whereas you know the other nitrification is the making of nitrates from the organic matter, whereas ammonification is formation of ammonia, okay? And nitrogen fixation is conversion of dinitrogen into usable form, soluble form into ammonia. Now, what is fermentation? You know, fermentation can be aerobic as well as anaerobic, wherein the carbohydrates are converted into gaseous end products with the help of many of the yeast as well as bacteria. Question number 38, the following figure shows a typical biogas plant. Select the right option in which products labeled as A, B and C are correctly identified. Dear students, if you see the diagram given, A is the gas, you can say it is the holder, A is the gas holder, B it is a methane vent, or you just methane they have given, B is the methane, sorry, B is the dung or water, it is D. Okay, so B is the dung or water, whereas the B, it is a methane. D is the methane. C is sludge. So A, gas holder. B, dung and water. C, sludge. D, methane plus carbon dioxide. So option number 2 is the correct answer. I'll explain once again. B, it is cow dung plus water. D, it is methane vent. It is methane vent. Whereas A is the gas holder. It is a gas holder. C, it is sludge. Right? So the option number 2 is the correct answer. Question number 39. Find out the pairs which are correctly matched. Find out the pairs which are correctly matched. Students, you could see that column 1, you have cyanobacteria, pesticides. So they are asking for the right pair. Now, if you see cyanobacteria, biopesticides, no, it's not the right. Because cyanobacteria, they are used to enhance the nutrient quality of the soil. So it should be biofertilizer. It is also wrong. Mycorrhiza, solubilization of phosphate. Yes, it is true. Bacillus, cry protein threonine. It is also correct. Single cell, rhizobia. There is no connection. Now, among the given options, if you see, B is 2, C is 3. But the given options, they have only there. A is 2. A cannot be 2. It is wrong. C and 3, they are right. C and cry protein thuringiensis, that is bacillus cry protein thuringiensis, is right. C and 4, bacillus and rhizobia protein, it is also wrong. A and 3, that is cyanobacteria and cry protein, it is also wrong. So option number 2 is the correct answer. Question number 40. Which one of the following is an example of carrying out lifecycle control of pests? You make it as pests, diseases using microbes. Dear students, you know that the example for carrying out biological control of pests, diseases using microbes is Trichoderma species. In your textbook, they have clearly given that the Trichoderma is a free living, it is a free living fungi found in the root ecosystem. Fights the pests and disease of many plant pathogens. Several plant pathogens. So option number 1 is correct, whereas nucleopolyhedrovirus against white rust in Brassica. Now we know that nucleopolyhedrovirus is a genus where baculovirus, one of the virus, it is a pathogen that controls most of the, you can say, the insects. So it is best insecticidal. It is a narrow spectrum insecticidal. You know, BT cotton offers resistance to most, you can say, insects. Again, it is also insecticide. Okay. Whereas fourth, ladybird beetle, it is the beetle that controls the aphids. These aphids, they consume plant sap. So it is again insecticidal. So the best biocontrol pest is Trichoderma species. So option number 1 is the correct answer. The primary treatment of sewage involves. Now, dear students, we have learned that in the primary treatment, it is also a physical method. It involves 2 steps, that is filtration and sedimentation. and sedimentation. So the primary treatment of sewage. So filtration, you know, the floating debris is taken out with the help of filtration, floating debris, whereas the grit, that is sand and small pebbles, they are taken out with the help of sedimentation. So in the given options, option number three, that is sedimentation and filtration, is the correct answer. You know, digestion, again, you will learn anaerobic digester, sludge digester, whereas decomposition, you know, it is a decaying process, or none of these. All the other three options does not suit the statement. That's why option number three, that is sedimentation and filtration, is the right option. Question number 42. The amount of oxygen required by the microbes in the decomposition of organic matter is called. Now, dear students, you know that the whatever the organic matter is present in the water, if the organic matter is more, then is less of oxygen. Then less of oxygen means the most of the flocs which are there, they will die. Now, BOD is a measure that estimates the amount of oxygen required by microorganism to degrade all the organic matter present in 1 liter of sample. So the amount of oxygen required by the microbes in the decomposition of organic matter is called, okay, it's a biochemical or biological oxygen demand. Okay, so you know the other definitions. 43, flocs refer to. Now it is a very simple question. Flocs, as already we have discussed, the masses of bacteria associated with slime or fungal filaments to form mesh-like structure, we call it as flocs. In the secondary treatment, so option number one is right. Primary sludge formed in ETP, this is wrong. The remaining part of the sludge, it is also wrong. Biogases formed from the home, it is also wrong. So option number one, masses of bacteria associated with fungal filaments to form mesh-like structure, it is the correct answer. Question number 44. Select the correct statement for the following. Activated sludge sediment in settlement tanks of sewage treatment plant, rich source of aerobic bacteria. Biogas, option number two, biogas is produced by the activity of aerobic bacteria on animal waste. Option number three, Methanobacterium is an aerobic bacterium found in rumen of cattle. Option number four, biogas, commonly called as gobar gas, is pure methane. Dear students, if you see the four statements, the activated sludge sediment in settlement tanks of sewage treatment plant is a rich source of aerobic bacteria. It is holds good. Biogas is produced by the activity of aerobic bacteria on animal waste. It is a wrong statement, because you know biogas is produced by the three-step anaerobic process, not aerobic process. Now, Methanobacterium is a anaerobic. It is an anaerobic. The given statement here, it is aerobic. So this also wrong. Biogas, commonly called gobar gas, is pure. No. Gobar gas or the biogas, it is a mixture of methane, carbon dioxide, H2S, and hydrogen. Right? So this statement is also wrong. So among the given options, option number 2, 3, and 4 are incorrect, whereas option number 1 is the correct statement. So option number 1 is the right answer. Question number 45, what is correct? So they have given four statements. They have asked us to find a correct statement. Legumes fix nitrogen through bacteria in their leaves. Legumes, option number two, legumes fix nitrogen through bacteria in their roots. Option number three, legumes fix nitrogen independent of bacteria. Option number four, legumes do not fix nitrogen. Dear students, we know that the rhizobium is a symbiotic nitrogen fixer. So it forms nodules on roots of leguminous plants. Right? Since they have asked about leguminous plants, we know that roots is the site where the bacteria, they fix the nitrogen. So option number two is the correct answer. Whereas rest of the statements, 1, 3, and 4, they are incorrect. Question number 46. A common biocontrol agent for the control of plant diseases is? Well, students, again, here given options, if you see, they have asked for a common biocontrol agent for the control of plant disease. Already we have discussed Trichoderma is there, which is the best biocontrol agent for the control of plant diseases. So option one is the correct answer. Whereas baculovirus, it is an insecticide. Bacillus thuringiensis, again, it is a resistance against various insects. Glomus, you know, it is a endomycorrhiza, which provides nutrition to the plants. So option number one, Trichoderma is the biocontrol agent that could be used for against many of the plant pathogens. Question number 47. Match column 1 with column 2 and select the correct answer from the codes given below. Column 1, it should be column 1. Here it is column 2. Column 1, Trichoderma, you know, it is a biocontrol agent. Streptomyces, you know, it is Streptomyces lactis. It produces lactis. Streptomyces lactis. It is a bacteria that forms lactic acid. Nitrosomonas, nitrification. We know that Nitrosomonas. Lactobacillus. Students, I'm sorry. Lactobacillus is the lactic acid, whereas Streptomyces is the source of antibiotics. Is the source of antibiotics. So Trichoderma A, it is 2. B, it is 4. C, it is 1, and D, it is 3. So A, 2, B, 4, C, 1, D, 3. Option number 2 is the correct answer. Question number 48. Match column 1 with column 2 and select the correct answer from the codes given below. Column 1, Ganga Action Plan. So we know that the Ganga Action Plan, where the Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, and West Bengal, these are the three states that come under this, where the main purpose was to set up the sea waste treatment plants, STPs. So Ganga Action Plan was formed with the effort of Ministry of Environment and Forest. Ministry of Environment and Forest under the project National River Commission Authority, NRCA. National River Commission Authority, it was the one. Under this, the Ganga Action Plan was initiated. So, A is 2. BT cotton, we know that it is insect resistant plant. BT cotton is insect resistant plant. So B is 3. Rhizobium, it is a nitrogen fixing bacteria. So C is 1. D, nostoc, it is nitrogen fixing cyanobacteria. It is nitrogen fixing cyanobacteria. So A 2, B 3, C 1. C4, D1. So A is 2, B is 3, C is 4, D is 1. Option number 1 is the correct answer. Question number 49. Match column 1 with column 2 and select the correct answer from the codes given below. Column 1, mycorrhiza. You know mycorrhiza, it is phosphorus nutrition. Bacillus thuringiensis, it is bioinsecticide. Root nodules, it is leg hemoglobin. Biopesticide is azadactin. It is a natural insecticide. So A is 2, B it is 3, sorry, B is 4, C root nodules it is 3, biopesticide it is 1, that is D is 1. So option number A, B is 4, C is 3, D is 1. Option number 3 is the correct answer. Question number 50. Which one of the following pairs is correctly matched? So they have given 4 options and they are asking for the correct match. We have rhizobium, parasite in the roots of lignin, it is a wrong statement. Mycorrhiza, mineral uptake from soil, it is correct. Yeast, production of biogas, it is wrong. Mycomycetes, the diseases ringworm, it is also wrong. Dear students, we know that the mycorrhiza are the fungi that forms association with roots of higher fungi. Now, rhizobium, it is a bacteria that forms association with the roots of leguminous plants. Yeast, they are used in the production of beverages, alcoholic beverages. Myxomycetes, again, they are the pathogens, cause many of the diseases. So, but the ringworm, it is caused by different organism, right? So the right or the correct matching here is mycorrhiza, mineral uptake of soil. Because mycorrhiza, you know, they help in the solubilization of phosphate as well as enhanced water absorption. And it also enriches the soil by secreting minerals. Question number 51. What would happen if our intestine harbors microbial flora exactly similar to that found in the rumen of cattle? Dear students, we have learned that the cattle falls under ruminants. Now, ruminants are those animals that have four-walled or four chambered stomach, four walled chambered stomach. Among the four stomachs, we have one part which we name it as rumen. Now in this rumen, what will happen? There is the presence of anaerobic bacteria, which we name them as methanogens. These methanogens, they consume the cellulose, which are the polymers of D-glucose, and convert them into various organic acids. Now, if you see among the given options, they have said what would happen if exactly this system, if it is incorporated in human beings, we could easily digest the cellulose present in our foods. That is the only option. Now, option number one, able to digest the all substance present. All substance, it is not possible. Even if you eat some of the lignin-rich compounds, then also you cannot metabolize them, because lignin is not digestible, or it cannot be broken down under anaerobic conditions. Whereas cellulose digestion is also very slow process compared to other organic substrates. So unable to digest the cellulose present in, it is also wrong statement. Produces organic acid, this is also wrong statement. Able to digest the cellulose present in your foods, it is the correct statement. So option number 4 is the right answer for question number 51. Which of the following microbes, question number 52, which of the following microbes is useful in biotechnology? Option number 1, dragonflies. Option number 2, ladybird. Option number 3, Bacillus thuringiensis. Option number 4, trichoderma. Dear students, among the four given options, if you see, the modern technology is biotechnology, where we have incorporated the gene isolated from Bacillus thuringiensis for offering the resistance to many of the insects to our crops. The example is BT cotton, where we have incorporated the gene, the cry protein gene, into the cotton plant. Similarly, you have BT brinjal, BT tomato, many are there where we have isolated the gene from Bacillus thuringiensis to offer the resistance in plants against many of the insects. So option number 3 is the correct answer. Dragonflies, you know, they are used as a predatory mechanism to control the mosquitoes. Whereas ladybird beetles, they are used to control the aphids. These are, trichoderma is used to control the plant pathogens. So the organisms which are used are the Bacillus thuringiensis. Option number 3 is the correct answer. Question number 53. If wheat field, kindly correct it, it is F-I-E-L-D. If wheat field is inoculated with rhizobium. Dear students, we know that only rhizobium is nitrogen fixer when they have their partner, that is leguminous plants. The leguminous plants such as the cowpea, ground pea, where the nodules are there, such plants you will find the rhizobium. But wheat, you know, they don't fall under the leguminous plants. So there you will not see fixation of nitrogen. So among the given option, option number one, soil will become nitrogen rich. It is incorrect. No effect on soil nitrogen. Yes, soil will be depleted of nitrogen. It is not. Soil will become rich in calcium. No. So among the four options given, option number two, no effect on soil nitrogen, is the correct answer. Question number 54, which group of bacteria found in both the rumen of cattle and sludge of sewage treatment? Just now I have explained rumen, which is a part, one among the four chambers of ruminants. Their rumen part, you will see rich microbial activity and it is anaerobic environment. So the presence of methanogens. There would be methanogens. Even if you see in sewage treatment, once the flake, they sediment at the bottom, in anaerobic sludge digesters, the anaerobic methanogens, they consume these bacteria and fungi and they release the methane, carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide and hydrogen. So these end gaseous end products are formed by feeding on the organic acids. Job is done by methanogens. So option number one, it is wrong. Glomus, it is wrong. Oscillatoria, it is wrong. Methanogens, it is the correct options. So option number 4 is correct answer for question number 54. The next question, question number 55. IPM is, dear students, while studying the biopesticides, we have learned that the use of baculoviruses of the genus nucleopolyhedroviruses, they are the narrow spectrum insecticides. Okay, they are the narrow spectrum insecticides which are used in the integrated pest management. Now, what is this integrated pest management? It is an ecosystem sensitive approach. We can say it is ecosystem sensitive approach. Here we often use approaches to minimize the pests and don't disturb the other useful organisms depend on these pests. Meaning what? It is an approach wherein we use the biocontrol method, we use the habitat manipulation, we use the cultural practices which don't hamper our soil. So these are various approaches that are used to minimize the effect caused on non-target organism, non-target organisms. So IPM is Integrated Pest Management Program. The farmers who follow the organic farming, they generally employ this Integrated Pest Management Program. So IPM stands for Integrated Pest Management Program. That is the option number 3. Question number 56. Why are flukes important in biological treatment of waste water? Dear students, you know that the biological treatment is a second step, which is also called as secondary treatment, where we have learned that the organic matter which is there, or the effluent from the primary treatment, we call it as primary effluent, It is transferred to large aeration tank where we mechanically agitate. We agitate mechanically and pump air into it. For the reason, for vigorous growth of useful aerobic bacteria. Now, these useful aerobic bacteria, they convert the organic matter into organic acids. Now, organic matter where the BOD is very high, we reduce the BOD so that the water is again, or it is able to have more oxygen in it. So, more the BOD, more the toxic or pollutant is the water, less the BOD, less the pollutant. So why are forks? Forks are important because microbes present in fork consume the major part of organic matter in the effluent, significantly reduces the BOD. So option number two, significantly reduces the BOD is the correct statement. Option number three, form components of activated sludge. It is also correct. Microbes present consume the major part of organic matter. It is also correct. So option number four, all the above are correct statement. So all the three statement, that is microbes present in the flocs consume the major part of the organic matter in the effluent. Option number two, significantly reduces the BOD, that is biochemical oxygen demand of the effluent. Option three, form components of activated sludge. All three statements are correct. So all of the above is the right answer. Question number 57, the technology of biogas production was developed in India mainly due to the efforts of. Dear students, I have explained to you yesterday that because of the efforts of the ARI and KVIC, that is Indian Agriculture Research Institute and Khari and Village Industries Commission, the biogas plants were set up among the rural areas because you will find more number of cattle used for various purposes in the rural areas rather than the urban areas. So most of the biogas plants were set up in the rural areas with the efforts of Indian Agriculture Research Institute and Khadi and Village Industries Commission. So option number one is correct, whereas rest of the options, the National Botanical Research Institute, where you will have most of the herbariums. ICMR is related to the medical research, where any new bacteria that are tolerant to the antibiotics, such studies are conducted there. Indian Council of Agriculture Research, it is the overall, you can say, which handles most of the national institutes regarding the germplasm collection. So the option number one, Indian Agriculture Research Institute and Khadi and Village Industries Commission, is the correct answer. Question number 59. Select correct option for secondary treatment or biological treatment. Statement 1, the primary effluent is passed. The primary effluent is passed into large aeration tanks where it is constantly agitated mechanically and air is pumped into it. which allows vigorous growth of useful aerobic microbes. It is correct. Option number two, aerobic microbes consume the major part of the organic matter in the effluent, which significantly reduces the BOD of the effluent. It is also correct. The greater the BOD of wastewater, more it is polluting potential. So sewage water is treated till the BOD is reduced. It is also correct. In a settling tank, bacterial flocs are allowed to sediment, and this sediment is called primary sludge. It is wrong because we call it as activated sludge. Option fifth, a small part of primary sludge is pumped back into the aeration tank to serve as the inoculants. Now again it is wrong. We use small part of the activated sludge as an inoculant. So option number 4 and 5 are incorrect. Option number 6, in anaerobic sludge digesters, other kind of bacteria which grow anaerobically digest the bacteria and the fungi in the sludge. This is right. In anaerobic sludge digesters, methanogens, they digest the bacteria and the fungi of the flocs, right? Option number 7, during anaerobic sludge digestion, bacteria produce biogas such as methane, hydrogen sulfide, and carbon dioxide. It is also the right statement. Students, there is a small error present in the options. Option number 1, as we have already discussed, option number 4 and 5, they are incorrect. Rest, option number 1, 2, 3, and 6, as well as 7, option number 1, 2, 3, 6, and 7 are right. Option number 4 and 5 are incorrect. So option number 2 is the correct answer. There has been a typographical error. You include 1 also. Okay. So it should be 1. 1 also you include. So question number 59. Option number 2 is correct. Additionally, we have to write 1. Question number 58, which is the incorrect for sewage treatment? Which option among the given options? We need to find which statement is incorrect. If you see, students, the option number 1, major component of municipal wastewater, human excreta, which also called sewage. Major component of municipal wastewater, yes, the municipal wastewater, its major component is human excreta. This is right. Sewage contains large amount of organic matter and microbes. Sewage contains large amount of organic matter and microbes. This is also right. Before disposal, sewage is treated in sewage treatment plants to make it less polluting. It is correct. Option number 4, treatment of wastewater done by the heterotrophic microbes naturally present in the sewage. This is also right. Primary treatment involves physical removal of particles from the sewage through filtration and sedimentation. It is right. Debris of removed by sequential filtration and grit are removed by sedimentation. This is also right. Option number 7, all solids that settle from the primary treatment called secondary sludge and the supernatant forms the effluent. This is incorrect because primary treatment the Sedimentation, we call it as sludge, and the sludge is primary. And the sludge is primary. So it is not secondary, it is primary. Secondary sludge is called activated sludge. Okay, so among the four given options, if you see, only 7 is incorrect here. So only 7 is incorrect. This is the right answer. Option number 3 is the right answer for question number 58. Question number 60. Assertion. Secondary treatment of sewage is also called biological treatment, while primary treatment is called physical treatment. Reason: primary sewage treatment depends upon only sedimentation properties of the material present in the sewage and filtration. So they have said that secondary treatment of sewage is also called biological treatment, while primary treatment is called physical treatment. Primary sewage depends only upon sedimentation properties of materials present in the sewage and filtration. Yes, this is true. But if you see, the assertion and reasons both are true, but they are not connected. The reason is not the correct explanation of the reason is not the correct explanation of assertion. So among the four given options, option number 1, if both assertion and reason are true, and reason are true and reason is correct, this is wrong. If both assertion and reason are true, but the reason is not the correct explanation of assertion, this is correct. So option number 2 is the correct, because both are individual statements. They are not correct explanation. Question number 61. Assertion. Dragonflies can be used to decrease occurrence of diseases like malaria and dengue. Yes, we know that dragonflies, they act as a biocontrol agents for the controlling mosquito larvae. Now we know that mosquitoes, they spread malaria, dengue, chikungunya, such diseases. So we can use the biocontrol agents dragonflies to control them. Reason: bacilloviruses are effective in controlling many insects and other arthropods. Yes, but they are nowhere connected again. So here we can say that if both the assertion and reason are true, but the reason is not the correct explanation of assertion, again it is option number 2. Question number 62. I hope 61 is clear to you. Dragonflies, it is an individual statement. Bacilloviruses, they are narrow spectrum insecticidals, which is used against many insects and other arthropods. But the reason is right, not the right explanation of assertion. So if both assertion and reason are true, but the reason is not the correct explanation of assertion, so option number 2 is the correct. Question number 62. Nitrogenase enzymes gets inactivated in presence of oxygen, yet nitrogen fixation occurs in aerobic cells of leguminosals. Dear students, we know that though rhizobium are found free living naturally in the field, but if they have the right partner, then only they are able to fix the nitrogen, that too when they form the nodules. Now we have learned that the nodules of leguminous plants, they have a pink pigment, which we call it as leg hemoglobin. Pink pigment, leg hemoglobin. This leg hemoglobin, it protects the nitrogenase enzyme, because nitrogen enzyme is very sensitive to the oxygen. So this particular leg hemoglobin, it does not allow the oxygen to react with nitrogenase, so that nitrogenase can fix the nitrogen. Now reason: leg hemoglobin allows the presence of oxygen just sufficient for respiration only. Now, if you see the statements, nitrogen enzyme gets inactivated in presence of oxygen, yet nitrogen occurs in aerobic cells of legume nodules. Yes, it is true. Reason, yes, legume allows presence of oxygen just sufficient for cellular respiration only. So the reason is right. So here, if both assertion and reason are true, and the reason are true and reason is correct explanation of assertion. Option number one is the correct explanation of the, you can say reason is the correct explanation of the assertion. So dear students, I have discussed around 62 questions until now, and there were two typographical errors for which I regret the typographical errors which has happened. So if tomorrow we have the test, NEET weekly test, I wish you all the best of luck. I conclude here. Thank you.